So I'll briefly explain the new return design. It will take about 6 months for GSTN to prepare the software for it. So for the period of next 6 months, the current arrangement of 3B and GSTR1 will continue. So that is the first thing. That is the first phase of transition. So for the next 6 months, GSTR3B and GSTR1 filing will continue. In the second phase, then we will move on. But before that, let me explain to you what the return will look like. After 6 months, what is the new system of return that will be there? There'll be a single monthly return for everybody, except composition dealers and except people who have got zero transaction during the trimester. Now those people will be allowed to file quarterly return. If you do not have any transaction, and today also we find that out of returns which are filed, about 30% returns are nil returns. There are no transactions which are reported. So those people will get the benefit of filing a return once in a quarter, and composition dealers are already having that facility of filing a return once in quarter only. But other than these two category of people, the remaining people will all file one single return per month. And that return will contain the details. In case of B2C, it will contain the details of total turnover. And in case of B2B, it will have to have the details of all the sales invoices which are there with that dealer. Whatever sales he has made, in case of B2B, he will have to put invoice-wise detail along with four-digit HSN code. Now, this is what it will have to have. In the transition phase, that is after 6 months, even after the return is prepared, the return design itself will have one separate column in which the dealer will be able to claim provisional credit based on his own calculation. Now this will continue for a period of 6 months. The second phase of transition will continue for a period of 6 months, which means that for 6 months, we will allow provisional credit to be taken by the dealer irrespective of whether the seller from whom he has bought the goods has uploaded the invoice or not. Irrespective of that, we will allow him the provisional credit to be taken for a period of 6 months. But during these 6 months, the GSTN will continuously feed information to that dealer about what is the gap between what he is claiming as provisional credit and what he is supposed to get as per the invoices which are uploaded by his sellers. So that gap percentage will be known to him, and he will try to bring this gap down over a period of 6 months. In the first month, he may find that the gap is 30%, but he will call up his seller and say, why are you not filing my return? Why are you not filing my invoice? And the seller can then upload invoice, and then again the gap will come down. So that way we will try to bring down this gap between the provisional credit claimed and the credit which is otherwise admissible as per the seller's information. And after 6 months, once we find that the rate is reducing, the gap is coming down, we will switch over to the actual implementation of the GSTR new return system, in which all B2B sellers, B2B people will have to put details of all their sales invoices. And the only way to get input tax credit will be if your seller has uploaded the invoices online. So that is the only way to get input tax credit. So that means there will be no further return procedure to be filed. As long as every seller has put all the invoices online, the return for everybody will be generated automatically by the computer. Based on your own sales details, the output tax liability will be determined by GSTN and auto-filled in your GSTR return. And based on the sellers who have uploaded the invoices, the input tax credit will be auto-populated by the computer. So it will become a completely automatic system of return filing, in which there will be absolutely no hassle. But having said that, we are saying that the only way to get input tax credit is if your sellers have uploaded the invoice. If they have not uploaded the invoice, then you will not get the credit. But that is in the third phase. So the first phase of 6 months for preparation of software, the second phase of getting provisional credit for a period of 6 months, and the third phase will be when no credit will be admissible unless the seller has uploaded the invoice. Having said that, let me also say that that does not mean that if the seller uploads the invoice It is a right of buyer to get credit. If the seller, after having uploaded invoice, does not pay the tax to government, the government will still retain the right to, first of all, go after the seller. We will try to recover it from the seller. But if the seller is not able to pay for whatever reason, suppose he runs away or he is a bogus party, then the recovery, the government will retain the right of recovering it from buyer also, but through a due process of law, by giving an automatic notice through the online process, and then by allowing him the opportunity to be heard, and then the government can still recover that from the buyer. So this will become a simple system of filing return. There will be unidirectional flow of invoices. Earlier system had cross movement of invoices. So earlier system said that the seller will upload invoices, then the buyer will see what are the missing invoices, the buyer will then upload the missing invoices, and then the computer will match, and then accordingly the input tax credit will be granted. All this is going away, and there will be only single return with details of all the sales invoices to be filed by everybody. Nobody needs to put any purchase side invoice at all. Now this, in short, is the system.